Art O'Cal for ESPN Esports here at US Bank Stadium in Minneapolis, Minnesota. It's the 2019 X Games, and Rogue Huskers will be competing in the ESPN EXP Apex Legend Invitational Tournament. Him and his team, one of the 15 teams invited for this tournament. Five other teams did qualify. Give us some overall impressions, first of all. We're here in the stadium. It's got a really cool setup. You saw the Apex setup, the overall X Games setup. What are your thoughts on this whole setup here?
Yeah, it's amazing. I mean, they have some of the best production people working this tournament, and it's just an honor to be able to play in the US Bank Stadium and compete alongside, you know, all these professionals in like the BMX and skateboarding events. So it really is humbling for sure.
You're one of the few teams that has actual custom lobby experience going into this tournament. You guys have had some success as well. How much of an advantage do you think that's going to be going into this tournament?
I think it's definitely important to have some LAN experience. The only other Apex LAN that we've played was the one that was at TwitchCon EU in Berlin. But previous to that as well, my teammates and I also played in H1Z1, and we played in several LANs for that. But it's definitely important, in my opinion, because it kind of calms your nerves. You know, you're not shaking as much when you're on that main stage. So I think that definitely gives us a little bit of like an advantage against the other teams.
When people are analyzing this tournament or giving predictions, really the two teams that they're talking about, for the most part, are Rogue and NRG. Mm-hmm. Do you prefer being in that favorite role, or would you have rather been perhaps an underdog going into a tournament like this?
I think I personally like being in that spotlight just because it's just nice to like have that attention. But it definitely does put a lot of pressure on us to, because people have, you know, big expectations for our team. You know, they want us to perform well, so, but I do enjoy it, I think.
Yeah, tell us about the makeup of your team. How would you describe your style of play?
So my teammate Dropped is like our IGL or our shot caller, and then myself and Sweet are more of just like the slayers and support players. And we try to loot up early and not take any engagements, and then just try to rotate early and get a good spot like in the center of the safe zone. So that way, we don't have to, because like if you're late to rotate, especially in the first couple of zones, you just kind of run into a bunch of teams that are already trying to rotate, and it just puts you in a worse position later in the game.
Who are some of the teams that you really have your eye on and you've been scouting leading up to this tournament?
Definitely TSM and T1 are both really good teams going into this. NRG is also a great team. Like all three of the players on that team have amazing shots. So I'd probably put those in like my top three, not including my team.
So this tournament is happening at X Games this weekend. They just announced Poland happening in September. It really seems like Apex Legends Esports is gaining momentum. How excited are you for what's to come in Apex Legends Esports?
Oh, I'm ecstatic. Like I just learned about Apex's plans for 2020, and they have a lot of really good stuff lined up, so I'm very excited.
Anything you can tell us on this camera here?
Not yet.
It'll be announced
soon.
Shakes her head no off camera? No? Okay, never mind. I tried.
It'll be announced soon, though. But, yeah, I mean, just myself and, like, both my teammates, like I said, we all come from H1Z1, which that went well for about 2 years, but kind of dropped off and died eventually. So we're just really excited to be able to stick to a game, hopefully for, like, another couple years and, you know, have there be lots of tournaments.
What are some things that you would change about the game? I know custom lobbies is the biggest top on the wish list for competitive players. What are some of the things that you would like to see changed as you get into a competitive season?
Well, I know there are a few complaints that a lot of the pros share. One being there's like an attachment in the game called Disruptor Rounds that you can put on the alternator. And a lot of pros think that it's still overpowered even though they've already nerfed it. So I'd like to see that either nerfed again or just removed from competitive play. And I also feel like the loot on the map, especially in tournaments like this where there's 20 pro teams in the game, loot is very like scarce. So I like to see the devs, maybe not for public games, but like for tournaments like this, just like up the loot counter, like maybe 1.5 times what it is now. I think that would make it easier for all teams.
Would you say that the game is in a good position? I mean, we've heard a lot about the Fortnite World Cup in recent times, just simply because of the prize pool and just the story of a 16-year-old becoming a millionaire overnight. But would you say that Apex Legends is in a very good position to get a good share of the BR esports infrastructure?
Yeah, definitely. I feel like Fortnite's kind of
I think they agree back there, just so you know.
I feel like Fortnite's kind of in its own world, but I think Apex definitely has what it takes to be like the one true competitive BR. Like I said, I feel like Fortnite is more, they focus a lot on like influencers and more like entertainment. So I think Apex Legends can definitely be the most competitive battle royale for sure.
Right. We're here at X Games. Have you talked with any of the competitors of other events about gaming? Have you heard? Were you surprised to hear any of the athletes were gamers themselves?
Actually, I really haven't talked with many, so I can't comment too much on that. But we haven't been getting any like weird stares or anything, so I think they're pretty welcoming.
Okay, something you can comment on before you go. We've been doing a lot of work with your assistant general manager, Glitter Explosion. She can't hear this right now. She's nowhere to be found.
Okay.
Give us the scoop. What is she really like? She's terrible, right?
No.
Awful human being. She's really difficult to work with. I'm really trying hard here.
No, if I'm being brutally honest, she's probably one of the best managers in the scene.
Yeah, she is.
She's always... she does everything for us. She's always on top of everything. Like, if we need something ordered, like a piece, like a mouse or something, we get it, like, ordered instantly. And she's always here to support us, so we couldn't really ask for more in a manager.
Yeah, I'm just kidding. She's pulling double duty, by the way, not only being assistant GM to Rogue, but helping us with our coverage here at ESPN Esports. Huskers, continued success. Thank you very much for your time.
For sure.
And keep it locked here at ESPN.com/esports.